His name is Vijay, and that's you know, as somebody who over 3.5 decades has covered almost 60 Grand Slam events and over 40 Davis Cup matches and hundreds of other tennis tournaments, I was just thinking 15 minutes before leaving the office to get here, if someday I sit down to write a book about my life in sports writing, and of course I write on many sports besides tennis, although tennis is my bread and butter sport. If I were to single out a moment as one of the top 10 that I've been part of and that I've been proud to have been part of, you know, in my entire 35 years of tennis writing, I'd say that 1998, watching Nirupama become the first Indian to win a Grand Slam singles main draw match, was one, you know. And I also remember my neighbor, and I've been a proud neighbor of this. I don't know how proud a neighbor that he's thought of me as, Bud Collins of the Boston Globe. You know, we've shared a desk in many, many Grand Slam events. And he came to me after Nirupama won and said, after Nirupama qualified, in fact, I said, of course, you know how tough it is for somebody to pronounce Indian names. So he said, Nirupama, do you know her? I said, yes, I do. And then he wrote a very good column in The Age for, about Nirupama. And it was great to have great to have somebody as great a tennis writer as Bud Collins write on an Indian sports person. And that was a very, very special day for Indian tennis. Of course, I've seen many, many special days for Indian tennis. Nirupama just mentioned 1985 and the match against Sweden. And last year, when India played a match in Bangalore, and one of our reporters from Chennai was assigned for the match, Ram Mahesh. He had many of the clippings from the old days, and then I was mentioning to him that although it was a dead rubber, one of the finest matches I've seen on grass was Vijay v. Vilander in a dead rubber on the third day in Bangalore. Of course, I've seen Vijay beat many great players in many different parts of the world. So it's been I think this effort of writing a book and just talking about the struggles, I'm sure Vijay and his mother, his parents, they're all familiar with the struggle of how to, get a champion in place and how to keep moving despite, keep moving despite all the hurdles. So it's a familiar story to me, but to make it familiar to the youngsters and to inspire them, especially the present generation of youngsters, they have so many distractions. It's very, very important for somebody like Nirupama to come up with something like this. And she sent me a PDF and I read parts of a story, and I must confess I haven't read the whole of it. I'd love to read the whole of it in one sitting at some point soon. And it's a great effort, and I wish her all the best in her forthcoming efforts. And I once again thank you all for giving me this few minutes on the dais, and thank you very much. Have a good evening.
Shekar. Mr. Vijay Amritraj needs no introduction. He was the captain of the Indian Davis Cup team for many years and helped India reach the finals in 1974 and 1987. With two quarterfinal appearances at US Open and Wimbledon, he attained career high ranking of 16. He was the UN Ambassador of Peace in 2001 and also started a non-profit organization called Vijay Amritraj Foundation that helps many charities across India. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 1983. Let us welcome Mr. Vijay Amritraj to launch the book, The Moonballer, and then address the gallery.
Thank you.
thrilled and delighted to hear about the book and to be asked to be here and be a part of this evening. Before I talk about Niru and the book, I would like to first congratulate the publisher for putting this book out. I think you've done a marvelous job. Congratulations to you, and I hope it does extremely well. To my dear friend Nirmal, who's known me a long, long time, and has been very kind to me in the press for many years, has probably written the best articles about me, both here and overseas matches that I've played over the last four decades that I've been involved with the game. And I've always found his writing of a particular match, good or bad, win or lose, and the way he's been able to express the story to the reader is so inspiring that it helps you want to either keep the story or make sure you tear it up immediately. But he's always written about a particular match where you can actually feel that you have watched the match once you've finished reading the story. And that has been the way that Nirmal Shekar has been writing. Yes. Niru was a youngster when I was playing, so I didn't really know her that well till much later on in life. And knowing how difficult it is, it has been in India, for any athlete to do well in any sport, which we found as we were growing up 35, 40 years ago, to be able to do something in a particular sport was very, very difficult. I remember numerous people asking my parents, yes, they play tennis, but what do they do for a living? Well, that's something that we hopefully put that question to rest after many years of being on the tour and people realizing that you could actually make a living from the sport. But I remember the one question my late grandmother used to say to me all the time, which I still was not able to answer, was, why do you have to go so far to lose? And we've all faced that, because we tend to lose more than we win. But I think when you grow up as a young boy and as a young man and eventually get to represent the country, which is the goal of all of us in any sport to be able to do, you don't realize how much more difficult it would be for a young girl to be able to do the same thing in our country. And this I'm talking about 30, 40 years ago. And then for someone like Niru to come out of our wonderfully conservative culture in the southern part of India and to be able to make it in a particular sport is a near impossibility. And she has spearheaded a real vitalization of sport in this country to be able to give an opportunity for great athletes to come out of this country in female in sports, whether it's a Saina Nehwal or Sania Mirza or anyone else that we would have seen, including, I guess, she was, P.T. Usha was before her, but she was of my age group that excelled in athletics. I know how difficult it would have been for them to be able to excel in sport with one goal in mind, and that is to be able to represent our country in a particular sport that we all love and have great passion for. So I think for her to have been able to come out, to have done so extremely well, won a national championship in the senior division at a tender age of 14, to be able to play in a Grand Slam, qualify and play in a Grand Slam and win a match, and put India on the map of female tennis, is quite unique, quite unheard of, raised goosebumps for everyone in this country in a particular sport, or sport across the board. And to be able to give that and to represent India in Federation Cup and women's tennis around the world as, at a young age, I can't even imagine what the parents were going through to be able to let a young girl like this go out and play all over the world. But at the end of the day, you've got to understand that a sport of our nature, and especially an individual sport, and I've said this time and again on television, that an individual sport builds the greatest character in an individual that anything could possibly do for you. Be it in politics, in entertainment, in business, in anything that you can possibly learn at school and thereafter, nothing builds character and teaches you more
than the sport does. And I think we've all grown better as people because of the sport that we play. And to be able to have people like the Nirmal Shekar write about our achievements, both good and bad, and to put us in our place when we do badly, to elevate us to the skies when we do well, are some things that it teaches us how to be able to live as a proper human being in a society that we've been brought up in and with a character that has been built in us. And the advantage that we have all had here, all of us in this room especially, and people, some of us who have played a sport at a high level, is the fact that we come from a society like the Tamil Nadu culture that gives us the ability to keep our head on our shoulders, to keep our feet on the ground, but still reach for the sky as we move forward. And I think this is what we are able to do as a family in India, in southern India, in Tamil Nadu, in our own conservative culture that we take abroad with us, and spread the word that it's not the food, that just the food that you would like, but it is certainly the culture that we bring to the table. And it is not impossible for us to excel and be the best that we can possibly be in a sport that we choose to excel in. And this is where someone like Niru has really stood up beyond reasonable doubt to be able to take not just her tennis and her achievements both overseas and in India all the way across the world, but also showcase our culture, our ability to get along with people, our ability to get along with family, and our ability to get along as a community. And I think all of this comes to the fact that she played tennis at the highest level, she represented the country at the highest level, she was able to share the wins and losses with her family and friends and with all of us across India, and for us to be inspired and be proud of someone like Niru who has done so well to represent our sport. Niru, well done. You are an absolute, a great achievement, not just for yourself and your family, but certainly for the country. I commend the publishers for taking this book out. I cannot wait to read it. I'm not quite sure you should have called it the Moonballer, because you can get to the net to win. I hope you teach people at the Nehru Academy to get to the net. I'm sure Nehru would agree with me. It looks better. I always thought it looked better. You got to look better rather than win. but at the end of the day, I did them both to some extent. But I'm really looking forward to reading this book, The Moonballer. I hope all of you will do too. My congratulations to you. My congratulations to your parents, your family, and your relatives who have supported you all through your career and continue to do so. Don't just share your wisdom to kids and juniors in the US. Bring your wisdom back to India as well, because we need it, not just for the boys and girls here, but for the community at large. And I hope we can both do that together. I look forward to that. But to all of you present here, you have honored Niru with your presence, you have honored the publisher with your presence, and you have honored Nirmal and me with your presence as well. We thank you. We thank you for your support all through the years, especially the wonderful journalists who have covered the sport for so many years and given us so much of your time and looked after so well in the press and on television and on radio. We thank you for that, and we hope you continue to do so in the future as well. As far as I'm concerned, I am honored and delighted to be amongst all of you and spend these few minutes with you. Thank you all.
I would now like to propose the vote of thanks. At the outset, I take this opportunity to thank all the people who have made this event a grand success. I would like to express my profound sense of gratitude and sincere thanks to our chief guest, Mr. Vijay Amritraj, and our guest of honor, Mr. Nirmal Shekar, for sparing their valuable time to be here with us today. Thank you, sir. I'm extremely grateful to Mr. Raghavan for getting the books out to you all. I earnestly thank all the media and press who are here today with us. This event would not have been possible without the timely help of Mr. Rajiv Vijay Kumar and Mrs. Sai Jayalakshmi in organizing this excellent venue, for which I am indebted to them. I place on record